Jack. You know how it go. You know how it go. You know how it go. Jack. You know how it go. Niggas be hating on the low. You know how it go. Go. They don't wanna see you grow. You know how it go. These niggas do the most. You know how it go. Grind 24. You know how it go. Jack. I'm used to living a fast life on the road. I was never on a roll. Student, but check my status, nigga, on the road. Everything great, a nigga, on the road. They ain't see me, so they create their own views of me. I'm running into the old niggas that used to jug with me. They ain't hear from me, so they asking what's good with me. You know, you know. You know how it go. Go. Says she hate me, then she love me, you know how it go. Go. Loco life, you know how I roll. Gotta get it in, you know how it go. R.I.P. my nigga, y'all. Jano. Watch out for them niggas that do the most. And watch out for niggas that say things as a joke. MMV fans, don't listen to all them rumors. You were acting, you were not a shooter. You know how it go. 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 Niggas be hating on the low. You know how it go. They don't wanna see you grow. You know how it go. You know. These niggas do the most. You know how it go. Loco. Grind 24. You know how it go. They see me up. Now they wanna get down. Should've been with the get down when niggas got down. So be humble, nigga, sit down. Was on my shit then, I'm on my shit now. Ain't shit changed, you know how it go. Shit change. Only 5'10", but keep it tall, my nigga. Check to the day that I fall, my nigga. Yeah, I got shit to live for, my nigga. But I'm going hard, ain't no going home. You know how it go. Go, 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 go. You know how it go. Check. 24 on the grind, you know how it go. This my block, you tryna grind, you know how it go. This nigga out of line, you know how it go. You now. Check. B.A.B. me will fuck it up, me full of stamina. B.A.B. me full of stamina. Stamina. Him a no gangsta, him nobody no. Nobody no. She no look the same after Grammy, you know. Catfished, you know how it go. Thought I had a bad bitch, you know how it go. You know. Before I sent her home, she still gon' get that dick, you know how it go.
You know how it go.
Man, I loco, you know how it go. 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 Niggas be hating on the low, you know how it go. They don't wanna see you grow. You know how it go. These niggas do the most. You know how it go. Grind 24. You know how it go. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Too many niggas stuntin' for the gram, nigga. Loco life, they understand, nigga. Too many niggas frontin' for the green, nigga. No cash, wrong team, nigga. My right hand itch more than my left, dude. My trigger finger itch more than my middle finger. Baby, I've been a ringer. I never, ever, ever turned down a fade. Got the 40 if it's sour, nigga, lemonade. Let me stimulate your mind before I penetrate. Put you in submissions, baby, MMA. Only if submissions, babe, to what I say. Does it even matter, baby, DM? Does it even matter, nigga, DM? Fresh teeth with some Nikes. Does it even matter, nigga, DM?
What's that shit you poppin' on the internet? Suck a nigga, you know we ain't in it yet. Shawty pop that pussy for a couple bands. I know you a freak out on your Snapchat. Light it up and pass that. All about the money with the cash at. $100 bills, $100 bills. All about the money is a back check. Hold her, let me backtrack. Then that ass is fat, she got a cash stacks. $100 bills, $100 bills. Extra maple syrup on them flapjacks. Hold up, wait. Bad bitch, she a Cuban. Hey, gang, so stupid. Pussy wet as a jacuzzi. I might sing to her like Lucci. Body right, my little pussy, baby. She give me everything, she a booster. Model type with the nice eyes and a bad temper, she ruthless. Hit the city link with BR. Back a bad bitch from the DR. Got buzz with me in the club. Niggas start dumbing once he turn the beat on. I'm inhaling all this weed smoke. Remy got me in beast mode. Play the game with no cheat code. Try ball hard like D-Rose. On point when I shoot. Empty out, then I reload. No cash with the wrong team. Hit the dab on them like amigos. On point when I shoot. Empty out, then I reload. No cash with the wrong team. Hit the dab on them like Nico. What's that shit you poppin' on the internet? Suck a nigga, you know we ain't in it yet. Shawty pop that pussy for a couple bands. I know you a freak all on your Snapchat. Light it up and pass that. All about the money with a cash at. $100 bills, $100 bills. All about the money is a bag check.
Yo, what's going on? You're now rocking out with the Maniac Experience. Today's Estry Media had a special guest. My boy rocked out for like 7-8 hours here. Yo, I was home, woke up early in the morning, I see him getting interviewed. I come in, he's getting interviewed. Yo, that's how you grind. Yo.
You know that.
Yo, man, much love, respect. Yo, let people know what your name is and all that.
BR, go by BR, BR Molly. Yay.
And if you got internet in your house, you know what this is then. Like, if you watch YouTube, you know who that is. You know what, he was one of the first shows that started off this YouTube series, the best show, still standing, like, and nothing came close besides, what's the other shit with my nigga? Respect Life. But besides that, there's nothing ever touching that. Like, that's good. Money Violence, man. Money and Violence,
respect,
man.
Respect.
What the fuck happened to Money and Violence, man? Let the motherfuckers know, because I need to know.
Man, they sold a show. So once they sold a show, it kind of like...
Went corporate.
Yeah. But when they sold a show, it like... It opened doors for the director.
Yeah.
Because he got a part of two other shows, which is a new show with Forest Whitaker and another one I'm not too sure of. But he had to do that, so that was a part of his deal as well. Once he sold the show to Lionsgate, so he worked with Forest Whitaker. He finished that show. I think he finished both shows. Now he's trying to get back Money and Violence from them because
they ain't do nothing with it.
Yeah, so he's trying to get it back from them. In the meantime, he's working on another show called The Spot.
Oh yeah, I seen that shit on YouTube, on social media.
Yeah,
but why would he sell that shit anyway? I understand cash, niggas know that kid. Niggas got kids, but you ain't the only one with kids, man. God damn, son. That shit could have went somewhere, man. Like, once you give it to the white people, they fuck it up. We all know that, man. Word. I ain't giving shit to the white man. Fuck that. If I don't even get no lawyer, I'm fucking representing my own stuff. I go, like, come on, man. They always want to touch our shit, then fuck our shit up. They took it from this man. Not to even do nothing with it. Like, that shit could have been... Oh, man.
Yeah, it would have took off way further than what it had already taken off, like, you know?
Yeah.
So I definitely dig what you're saying.
And from earlier, I heard you saying that you was only there for one show, and then...
They only wanted to keep me.
For one show?
Yeah.
Then you wind up just...
The stain. They end up keeping me.
Yo, I ain't gonna front, man. That shit, I never knew about it. My cousin put me on. He said, you know that shit, Money Violence? I said, what the fuck is that? Man, he put me on it. That shit was over, Jack. That shit was like Menace to Society. my nigga. Yeah, yo, that shit was the best show ever. I hope we get that shit back. You think it's too late?
Nah, because the skill that he's presenting it on now is bigger than it has ever been. Mm. Like, ain't nothing better than word of mouth.
Yeah, you're right.
Right? But now he's going international. You know what I'm saying? So he's want to put this on international television where it's being seen all around the world. That's a whole nother fan base.
Yeah, you're right. And then some of y'all grew due to all these years. They got more fans than I had. So Then y'all Uncle Murder on the show. Yo, that shit, yo.
Yo, it was.
And Uncle Murder guy, he signed with the unit now, so.
You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So if they bring it back the way they supposed to.
Facts, though.
It's going to be even better than
that. Facts, them. Though. Facts. It's going to be.
Oh, man.
A lot of people want to get. 50 should have got involved, man. All
right, now, he would have never got involved because one of the managers of Money and Violence, name is C Styles.
Mm-hmm.
You ever heard of C Styles?
Nah.
He produced a lot of records, even for 50 Cent.
Yeah,
he's known, you know, in the industry, you know what I'm saying? He's one of the managers behind the scene for Money and Violence. Him and 50 got their little...
drama?
Mm-hmm. You know, it ain't my business, so I ain't gonna speak on it too much, you know what I'm saying? But they got their little shit, and that's one reason why the show probably, I was saying, didn't make it where it's supposed to go. Because they got it sold the show to Lionsgate. Who also was signed to Lionsgate?
Oh,
50. With Stars TV.
So you think 50? Oh, this nigga 50, man. Damn, 50. Because then Ryan actually picked him up. Like,
so
Tidal, I mean.
Tidal picked up what?
The Money Violence at the beginning?
Yeah, that was for season two. That was for season two, but Tidal was just a stepping stone to get in the real bag.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? Lionsgate is the real bag.
You're right. Yo, man, I wish y'all motherfuckers come back, man. And hope all y'all come back, too.
Word.
Respect your jaw, nigga. Like, Chain, all
of respect your jaw. He ain't coming back because he died in the show. He died.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
Because it's been so long.
Yeah.
He did get murdered. Shane killed him.
Yeah.
Kane
killed him. He's definitely dead.
Damn.
Yeah, and then as far as him even having a chance of coming back around, he's killed himself doing that too.
Yeah, because he's
behind the scenes being a little.
You're right. Yo, that's a fact. See, he did like, I'm talking about Jay-Z right now. Uh-huh. Remember Jay-Z and they all broke up, whatever? Like, the Young Guns never talked bad about Jay-Z.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Biggs never talked bad about Jay-Z. Anybody who ever talked bad about Jay-Z, they done.
Yeah.
And I guess that's what Reeve did, whatever. Mm. I guess he's like, yo, you want to talk bad about me right now?
Yeah.
To everybody. But what about Migs then?
I don't really, like, nobody fucks with Boy. You know what I'm saying? He did it to himself too.
Yeah, he got too big, huh?
Yeah, he got big headed because he got little roles and yeah, but you didn't have a major role, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And then like you're getting picked up for roles that you can't even, like, I don't see how people really believed in. I'm not no hate, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. I don't see how people believed in his role, you know what I'm saying? Because he wasn't even that in real life, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, like, but it seems real.
I didn't see how, you know what I'm saying? Behind the scenes, I was like, I didn't see it on the screen. I didn't see it, but you know, to each his own. I'm a part of the movement, so I'm gonna wave it, shout it out, do whatever, you know what I'm saying? But he was never really that.
But
so
if you compare his part to Rafe part, Rafe shit. Look, Rafe, I always told my cousin, I'm like, yo, Rafe,
it's something about like
this thing. It's something about this thing. Like, I'm like, yo, he telling the story, son. Like, this nigga been through all.
Telling
like, you. You can't write this shit out. The shit that he's explaining for us, my nigga. Like, you have to been through that.
That's
shit.
Experience.
Yeah, you have to been through that shit. Like, ain't no writer in the world could do no shit like that. Unless you been through some shit
that's
like that. And I've been told my cousin that a long time ago, son. I'm like, yo, nah, son. Rafe had to been a gangster back in the days. Or his brother, somebody, son. Because this nigga, no, he playing this out too good. Like,
word,
too good.
Word. Like, I look up to that guy, Rafe, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, AKA the brother.
Yeah, Moses Vernu, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I look up to him, man. Like, he taught me a lot, you know what I'm saying? Being a part of that show, the whole movement.
Yo.
Behind the scenes, not even being a part of they're like, not even on set. I mean, like, behind the scenes, being around him, the nigga taught me a lot. Like, a lot as a man. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
He always give lessons.
Yes.
Do the show.
He's like that on the show. He's like that off the show.
I learned things from him. Do the show.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
So imagine if you are around him on a daily basis.
Facts,
you're going to learn a lot.
Yeah.
And then if you're a wildcat, like, I came up as a wildcat. You know what I'm saying? So when I was around him, I wanted to, like, kind of be like him. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm like, he's mad humble. And at the same time, you know the nigga get busy. You know what I'm saying?
You want him silent.
He want him silent. So I'm like, that's the official way carrying yourself like a man.
Yeah.
Official gangster, real G shit.
Yeah, yo.
Nah,
right.
Fuck a gang shit and all that. Yeah, I come up right. As some gang shit. You know what I'm saying? But fuck all that, my nigga. Like, if you don't know what it is to be a man first,
Then
fuck whatever it is you standing for right now as a man. If you got two balls and a dick hanging between your legs, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
If you don't know how to swing that, if you don't know how to really carry yourself as a man, my nigga, then
he was even showing. He was even showing Shane, like, the way I can tell, like,
in the show,
in the show,
out the show.
Yeah, I could tell. Like, he was showing Shane,
really,
like, yo,
like that. He's really like that. Like, it's times that I was going through things and I wouldn't be here right now. I'd probably be doing a bit, you know what I'm saying? Right. Like, Dearing Money and Violence. Like, behind the scenes, I'm still active in the streets, you know what I'm saying? So it's like him talking to me, he's like, yo, you shouldn't do this, BR, yo, BR, you shouldn't, boom, boom, boom. And it's like one day I'm in his crib and I'm talking to him about what I'm going through and I just start crying to him. You know what I'm saying? Like, crying, just opening up to him, like, yo, like, because I don't have nobody to talk to. Yeah. Like, when you in the, like, come on, I'm gonna be real as a man to man.
Yeah.
I'm a hood nigga. Uh-huh. I don't like opening up.
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Your business.
Nah, I don't like opening up. You know what I'm saying? So, when you, but you, I ain't gonna front, like, I don't wanna open up to certain people.
But him, you know, he ain't gonna run into your business.
Exactly. He's different. He's different. He's like talking to the wall. But the wall talking back.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You just know that wall ain't gonna talk to nobody else. You know what I'm saying? Because then them trying to talk to it, they gonna look crazy.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, you're right. You're
so
right.
I'm like, yo, like, he's really that person, and I respect him. I commend him for a lot because he came through. He's been through a lot himself. So,
yo, a lot of niggas. A lot of niggas, he the godfather of this motherfucking YouTube series shit.
A word.
A lot of niggas gotta pay homage.
He got to, and like, I always pay homage.
Like, BET will not BET give awards out to, like, somebody that gives him an award.
So. Yeah. He got an award too.
Yeah.
Yeah. He got a few awards for producing that.
Yeah, but he didn't like for being the father of this YouTube show. Uh-huh. Like,
yeah. You're right.
Taking
you're
this shit to another level, because if it wasn't for y'all show, these other shows wouldn't exist.
Yeah. He wasn't. He wasn't. He did get awarded for producing the first web series.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He was awarded for the first hit web series.
Because I would say, because if that shit would have flopped, then nobody would pay attention.
Nobody would have tried to pursue
exactly,
that lane.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Then you have Respect Life come behind y'all, and they're so good. Only thing I don't like, they take too long with the episodes.
Not only that, shout out to Boom, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. He's a cool dude too. He came to me presenting a role to me to be a part of that as well. Yeah. And I was like, I'm down. I'm like, I'm down, but I'm loyal to the MV movement, you know what I'm saying? If something was to happen to me on MV and I know for sure I'm no longer a part of that, then you know what I'm saying? But as long as I'm there, that's my family, you know what I'm saying? Like, whether I'm there or not, they're still my family, but fact. I'm working with them, and that's where my loyalty stands.
I think you stay in for the long run. Even if it's like it's not happening, because it's going to pop off. Right?
Stay down.
Stay down
until we come up.
A lot of niggas don't stay down. They just leave. So.
Yeah.
And leave because they hot for the moment.
Yeah.
Then when he pop back up, all y'all like this.
Yeah.
Y'all done bad mouth this nigga. Y'all done talk all crazy shit about him.
Yeah.
And that's what happened. See, like, my boy Young, I'll go back to Rockefeller. Young Chris. And I swear to my mother, before I even knew about Jay-Z paying Meek Mill, Bell, and all that shit, because that's some shit nobody know about. Look, Meek Mill's letting niggas know. 21 Savage shit. He helped everybody out. I told niggas, I like, yo, he's still helping Young Chris out. I bet you he told Young Chris he could do more for him, unsigned to him, than signed to him. And because Chris stayed loyal, he never talked, even when they asked him about taking his flow, Young Chris never said, Jay-Z took my flow. He always just like, stay down to Jay-Z. You know what I'm saying? I say that to say this. Rafe is like a motherfucking Jay-Z.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, shit might fuck up. No, man, everybody fuck up at the beginning. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? He probably made a mistake. But he learned it. I guarantee he's learning it because he's trying to get his shit back.
Exactly.
And like I said, got more fans, more money, and then more smarter.
But that's the main thing, though, that, like you saying, that's the main thing. And that's what I feel a lot of people lost sight of, because you all, especially those that are no longer with the movement, that created their own shit on a negative note, you know, y'all part of a show emulating somebody to be real. Old Brooklyn, right?
Yeah, facts.
But then when something really goes down in real life, you turn to a bitch. It's like, come on, my dude. It's like, come on, my dude. It's like, hello. Like, what do you want to be? Right? You know what I'm saying? Because who you are is really showing.
Yeah, facts.
You know what I'm saying? So I guess everything happens for a reason, and I believe in that too.
Yeah, I said, fuck it. I'm saying, I'm probably, your role going to be extra bigger. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I'm saying when that shit come back up, I know that shit gonna hit big TV. I know it's gonna hit big TV. And like I said, you rapping and all that.
Yeah,
too.
Yeah.
So like I said, so you ain't just wait. You around. Like, yeah. Fuck it, let me just make some music.
Well,
now.
He told me straight up, like, yo, BR, you're good. Mamba, you wasn't promised a role in this show. You created your own lane on the show. And creating your own lane, you also created a lane outside the show because I see you branding your own shit instead of branding.
I was seeing y'all doing like guest appearances and shit like that.
Walkthroughs. But at the same time, everybody was branding Money and Violence, Money and Violence, Money and Violence. I was doing that, but I was branding my own brand too at the same time.
Smart man.
You see what I'm saying? So that's how I was able to get known for the music now.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Where people are like, well, I fuck with his acting, but boy, he got some heat too. He got heat too. Y'all ain't hear a shit. So that's where it created that for me. And now I'm here pushing my first tape, which is Loco Living, drops on March 28th on my birthday too. That's my Loco day.
That's what's up. That's for sure.
So Loco Living is crazy, man. Y'all go check that out. Go check it on my page. You know what I'm saying? At BRMALIE. Go look on my page and check out the cover. It's fire. I did the artwork myself.
You draw?
Yeah, nah, I paint. I used to draw. Yeah, I draw. But I used to do art a lot, you know what I'm saying, coming up. So I actually did the paintings on the wall, designed everything myself, put the logos on the wall. Yeah, I did everything and just made it a cover. Just put a picture of myself standing in front of it and made it a real simple photo.
Check this out. One row, sign, set of chains.
Yeah.
Rapping. Nigga, now back to drawing, whatever. Like, I know you've been drawing since you was young.
Yeah.
Back to drawing. Like I said.
Yeah.
Like, niggas, man. Like I said, you never know, man. Always take one shot.
That's all it took.
One shot. And don't, you know.
Like M said, word.
And y'all role, which is the Jamaican crew, y'all played that fucking role. Like, y'all crew played that shit. Like, the barbershop role was crazy, yo. You heard? When they walked up in the barbershop, yo, because, man, that shit was.
That role was crazy.
That shit was crazy.
Nigga was eavesdropping on them in the barbershop. I'm like, how y'all niggas don't see this light skinned nigga sitting there eavesdropping on y'all, bro?
Crazy. Then at the end, when nigga was with the work, angle front, Jamaicans, man. I fuck with Jamaicans, man, because them niggas mad. Like, them niggas, I don't know, man. They conscious, like a motherfucker.
Yeah.
Like, but even in the roles, the big, I forgot his name. He was conscious, though, too.
Yeah.
And, like, you know what I'm saying? That role, like, Did they do any acting?
This is everybody. Let me say that this is everyone's first time acting. Every actor that was on MV, it was their first. As far as the main cast members, there was a bunch of people that were extras.
Yeah,
they have acted before, but all the main cast members have never acted before in life.
How y'all felt when Uncle Murder came over?
It was dope because Murder never acted before either. You know what I'm saying? So that was his first opportunity too. So everybody being there was just love because it was like common grounds for everybody because a lot of people had names. Niggas had clout.
Uh-huh.
You know, these were people coming in with reputable names coming down being a part of this movement. And we like, damn, just because of their clout, we're like, damn. But then they come on the set, they're acting more regular than us.
Mm.
They're looking at us, looking up to us, talking to us like we're bigger. And we like, what?
Y'all niggas is the motherfucker. Is that banana? That movement was crazy.
Y'all
still starred, but y'all was like, when that shit came out, man, like, yo.
Yeah, yeah.
Y'all was like the fucking Rockefeller, man.
Yeah.
In the early 2000s, my nigga. I wish, man, that I didn't argue. But like I said, man, it get greater later at the end of the day.
Yeah.
Yo, what's the song with the dress name, man? That Grammy motherfucker, man.
Which one?
It kept that Ray for like, yo, son, you stole like, you stole nigga money or some shit like that.
Oh, Black.
Black. Yo, that nigga was
Black.
Like, oh, my God. Black. Grammy motherfucker, man.
And Grammy Tile was Grammy too. The one I used to chill with, Shooter Shane.
Oh, yo, what happened to Tile?
I don't even know what happened to him. He died in the show too.
Yeah, I know. Fucking with niggas in East New York in the store.
In the show.
Yeah, he was the nigga from it was in East New York. The store had him shit in the store.
Yeah.
And shit like that. Yo, man. What's the other girl's name? It was Rafe's girlfriend.
Jessica.
She's still involved?
Nah, she died in the show too.
Damn, it was a long time, man.
Word.
Damn.
Yeah, he killed a lot of cast members at the season finale of season two.
Who thought of putting Uncle Murder and Shane?
Brothers.
Shane brothers. Like
Rafe.
Rafe? That was dope.
Yeah, he's genius.
That was dope. Like,
yeah.
Them niggas were like, it started looking like, it started looking like to me, my nigga. Like, yo, man, nigga said, shot that nigga in his back. Uncle Murder was a Grammy nigga. Yo, man, shout out to y'all niggas. I ain't gonna lie.
You shoot your own brother?
Yo, my nigga, this nigga
for the block.
For the block, Oka Murder was on some bullshit, and when I seen that script, I'm like, yo, this nigga, nah, son, you just can't write shit like this, man. Yo, shit like this is you, like, you know, a rapper and a nigga who just like been through this shit. Like, who putting words together? Oh, nigga. Because when you rhyme, you ain't got to. When you real, you ain't really got to rhyme all day. Like, you could just talk on the beat. And nigga, yeah, that shit is fire.
Yeah.
And like, you know what I'm saying? He ain't just a writer who went to school for this shit. This shit was like something like, yo, my nigga, this shit sound familiar. This story sound familiar. Like, did that go through some shit like this before? Like, word to mother, son. Like, and then they all played their role. Like, at the beginning, like, you know, they, you could tell it was a little shaky at the beginning, but the fans was like, fuck it. But it was shaky, but the what was going on, like the shootings and shit like that.
Yeah, the quality was bad at the beginning.
Everything was bad besides, but it still was the motherfucking shit that was happening. Like, now this shit gonna get better, son.
Mm-hmm.
This shit gonna get better. Nigga, oh, he shot that nigga in the head. Then we played the roof part when he was on the roof. What's the son name? The Chopper.
Chopper. Hold on. When he was laying down as the bum.
Yo, my nigga. Nah, son. Yo, it don't.
That scene was epic. Him being laid, pretending sitting there, just eavesdropping on their whole conversation, acting like a bum laying on the floor on the mat.
Y'all gotta put that shit on YouTube, like some top 10 highlights of Money and Violence, and just put all them shits up in a compilation of them shit. Like,
World Star
Hip Hop Fights and shit like that. You just put a compilation of. Cause they got mad. Yo, they got some shit, my nigga. And some shit you can use in real life, nigga, when you got drama. Nigga.
Yo, for real.
I'm telling you, nigga. Yo, Rafe can teach you some shit, man. Like, I know
funny thing is, yo, that you say that about real life.
Yeah.
A dude dressed up in one of Miz.
Wow.
Yeah, he got the same jacket as Miz from the show, put on a hoodie like Miz from the show, and did a shooting around the time of Money and Violence. It was on the news and all that.
Damn, so I'm telling you, but that shit right there was like some NW, like NW.
Yeah,
like,
that was crazy that yo, the dude looked exactly like Miz in his image, like in the shooting when they posted it. He looked like the nigga Miz, so it was funny as motherfucker. Like, everybody started posting it on the media like, yo, why did this nigga just pull the MMV stunt? And he got away. He never got caught.
Yo, man, like, yo, it's shit that's going down like a real life with me, right? And I just think, I'll be like with Rafe, because Rafe, he don't show no emotion. Like, he let you know, like, he's panicking like that. You won't even know.
Yeah.
And, like, he let shit slide. You think he letting shit slide. And that's how, like, I carry on now, like, you're not going to.
Nah, you got to be humble about
shit.
You're
not really going to know. I'm going to smack the shit out of you.
Yeah.
You ain't going to see it coming.
Yeah.
Like, I ain't going to walk past you and say nothing. Like,
yeah.
I'm just keeping my distance, what? And that's it. And I'm going to come back and smack the shit out of you. I learned that from Rafe, nigga. You all right, man? Because before, man, you was like, nigga, I'm going to smack the shit out of you. Like, you put a nigga on. And I ain't putting a nigga on. He don't know what's coming. I'm smacking a month later. 3 days later. He don't know where the smack came from. You know what I'm saying? Word to Bubba. So Rafe, he helping you with the music too, or he's just like?
Nah, he helped me with a lot of the behind the scenes for the videos.
Nice.
Yeah, so he has been helping me with the project in general, you know, with the.
That's a true friend.
Nah, he's a good person in general. You know what I'm saying? Friend. Like, he's a good person in general. Like, I fucks with him.
Cause usually niggas be like, if it's not what I'm doing, then I ain't got time for that.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, he'll hit you with that once in the blue too.
You know what I'm saying?
But he takes time out though. If he tell you right now, I'm busy, he gonna call you back. He ain't gonna try to forget you. So that's how you know it's genuine. Like, the nigga busy, he just busy, because he calls you back when he's home.
Mm-hmm.
And he be like, yo, I'm tired, but I just got home. He calls back though, so that's all that matters.
See, we need people like that. See, he learned from Rafe, like, he could pass it down to his young homies. You know what I'm saying? Then his young homie could pass it down to his young homie.
Yeah.
Like, it'll pass all that shit down. Cause
yeah.
A lot of these niggas need to be talked to, because these niggas out here moving crazy.
Yeah, they different.
You seen that YBM shit? They beat that little nigga up.
I didn't see it yet, but I keep hearing about it.
Personally, this is what happened with me. I'd have went to my label and told them, yo, thank y'all for everything y'all done for me. But I'm no longer a rapper. Like, I'm going to jail. I'm like, let's go right now. I'm going to kill these niggas. Like, you going to cut me, nigga? What the
he
fuck?
He cut him?
They cut the nigga and all that. But and it's a scalpel cut. And a scalpel cut. Come on, my nigga. Like, what was the beef about? What the fuck is that nigga's beef?
Yeah, I heard it was no real beef. I heard they just did it off of clout.
My nigga, I'm telling you, nigga, like, what the nigga from the Migos that Offset? Niggas, yo, clout chasing. Yo, niggas clout chasing out the all-time high. Niggas do anything for clout.
Yeah,
son.
I heard niggas saw him on a humble, saw him by himself, and was like, yo, ain't that such and such? Yo, we should take his chain.
For what? What you gonna do with it? You gonna wear it?
That's crazy.
And you still be broke? Like, leave these niggas alone, man. These niggas, what the niggas rappers, my nigga. Like, they entertain. And then some of them like that, some of them aren't like that. But
yeah.
Let them niggas live their life, my nigga. Yeah. Who the fuck is your bum ass? Nigga, pick up a pen and pad, start writing, nigga. Find your talent.
All right.
Why you always want to hurt a nigga? But like unless the nigga was talking crazy, then it's different. But come on, my nigga, you're running around with 20 niggas around your entourage, a bunch of bum ass niggas who ain't doing nothing. Like you around me, my nigga, you gotta learn how to do something. You better learn how to work a camera or something, nigga. Like
word.
You gotta, I don't need no goons, nigga. I'm good.
Word.
I'm good, nigga. I can hold my own stuff down, nigga.
Word.
I don't need like unless the niggas trying to fight. Hey, we gonna fight together, but I don't need y'all niggas around for that.
Word.
Then y'all YouTube and shit. Yeah, you're putting that shit on Instagram.
They said that's the crazy shit.
Yo, Instagram, man, is worse than crack, boy. It's knocking niggas. See, crack got the kids taken away. Instagram, niggas' life's getting taken away through Instagram. Niggas getting life. Like, in prison. Like, when the crack ever came, people were losing their kids. You know what I'm saying? Some got them back a couple of years later. But Instagram, this shit is taking niggas' lives, nigga. Like, niggas' Instagram murders. Niggas, yo, come on, son. When the fight break out, I don't want to pull out my phone, my nigga. That's not even the first thing on my mind, my nigga. My first thing in my mind, like, oh, I'm going to fuck up out of here, nigga. If a nigga start shooting, because I'll be damned if I get hit by a straight bullet. It ain't meant for me. I ain't trying to go out like that. Like,
I don't know about that.
Man, listen, man. That's what I'm trying to say. Like I said, man, see, you do one thing. You act and you rapping. Anything else you doing?
So I have drawing? My Local Life apparel coming.
Oh,
you know what I'm saying?
My boy, he ain't playing, man.
Yeah, yeah. I produced a few items already, a few pieces. People, you know, ate it up. They bought it, sold out. Then I came with another load and gave it out for free.
How much did you charge?
The t-shirts were $25. The sweaters were $40. I had sweatsuits.
How much you pay for them,
though? Yeah, I do, you know, I go wholesale.
I'm saying, you print them yourself?
Yeah, I do everything myself.
Oh, so you got the printer and all that?
Yeah, I got all that myself.
Oh, shit. Well, man, we're going to have to work with something now, man, because you know what I'm saying?
I got the embroidery machine as well.
Oh.
So I do the hats as well.
So yo, man. That's why I like doing podcast barbershop shit like this right here. You know what I'm saying? See, if I'm asking professional questions like, so what year you was born? I would have knew that shit. Because I'd have still been asking what part of the fucking New York you from. That's why I do barbershop talk. I'm not professional. I'm not looking, I don't got no laptop sitting up here. I ain't do no research. Whatever you want to talk to me about, we talked about.
That's what I talk about.
And I hate when niggas be asking niggas personal questions, my nigga. Like, why are you asking niggas so much personal questions, my nigga? Like, you seen the R. Kelly interview? All right. That bitch Gayle be bugging, son. Like, she, are you interviewing me or are you a cop? Like, I'm looking at the bitch like, is she a cop? Because she was asking nigga, why you was in McDonald's? Like, bitch, what the fuck you mean why I was in McDonald's? You asking mad, dumbass questions like she was a cop. I'm like, interviews be acting like the officers. I'm not a cop. I don't ask questions I don't need to be asking. These niggas be heard some shit in the street. Yo, so see, I heard.
That shit is fucked up with that whole R. Kelly situation.
Yeah.
Like, if R. Kelly really did do what they claim he did. Yeah. Yeah, man. Yeah, let that nigga fuck him. Yeah.
Yeah, but if he didn't,
come on, man. Y'all trying to fuck the nigga up. You know what I'm saying? And this will fuck him up.
My guess, he got somebody real pissed off.
Yeah.
Son. Like
somebody's parents.
Somebody in white America, nigga. My nigga, because
America?
Only white America could do this to you. They did it to Martin.
Yeah.
They did it to Dave Chappelle.
Yeah. Dave Chappelle came back nice, though.
Facts, though. Because, but a lot of
they did it to Bill Cosby.
Bill Cosby. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, see, they can't do shit like to me like that because my shit is the open book. I don't got nothing to hide. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, so what's up? I've been poor. So if I'm rich enough to take care of me and mine, man, fuck y'all niggas, man. I'm not taking a picture with no teddy bear in a fucking closet. I don't want no fucking monkey as a pet because every nigga with a monkey with a pet, you already know that nigga. You already know what happened. Man, I know niggas want to be wealthy, filthy rich, and I understand that. But god damn, son, these niggas be going the extra length. Like, you know what I'm saying? Damn, nigga, how much money you want? Like, the fuck? You willing to sell your whole soul? Like, come on, son. Niggas make these deals with the devil.
Then they try to
break the deal off, but if you, like, niggas be like, nah, it's over, nigga.
Oh, man.
It's over. And that's what happened. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, when you have, like, R. Kelly had a long ass run.
Yeah.
And look,
over like 20, 30 years, you said.
Runs don't last that long. Like, everybody get a dying point, like a little dry spot, like, oh shit, like, all right, my shit ain't hitting. Let me fall back for a little while. Like, when you hot that much and you ain't nobody that nice, you done this something in the back scene to keep yourself that hot. Then eventually you sit back, like, even with the chink shit, right? You know what I'm saying with the chink drug shit? I was like, before, whatever. I'm like, yo, he's fucking with French, right? You know what I'm saying? Whatever, whatever. And French, I think, I'm like, chicks made a deal probably with these niggas. You know what I'm saying? Now he's around the Kardashians, right? But then he looked, he's like, nah, fuck that. I'm out. I can't fuck with this shit. I made a mistake. All right, but you know too much now, nigga. I gotta get you out of here. Bow. Like, I've been thinking some crazy shit, because I believe what I see, nigga. And I see it, nigga. I mean,
that's a good perspective.
Like, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like,
because
when you want.
You never know.
Yeah, like, I'm listening to Ali Vegas, and Ali Vegas was on. He was saying shit like that. Like, his cousin got a modeling deal, and then they want the nigga to do some wild shit, like take a picture with a teddy bear, butt naked type shit, if you really want the deal. Nigga, like, what? Like, Tyson Beckham was there. He went in there. He like, nah, and he left the contract, all that shit on the table and left. Like, I'm good, my nigga. I don't need to be doing this shit. Everything is just bugging.
What kind of teddy bear? Like, was it a gay look?
Like, yeah, a rumor is a rumor. But when it was being said by more than one person, like, millions, a lot of people, it's not a rumor no more, it's the truth. Like, so this is the truth. I know what it was. Like, they'd be asking how bad you want the fame. You know what I'm saying? Do you want the fame? All right, so, you know what I'm saying? Just, they have you take some weird pictures, and they hold it in the envelope, so, and you act crazy, they fuck you out. They fuck you over, my nigga. All type of shit. They control media. So, you know what I'm saying? They can make you look good. Like, Tebow. They can make, remember Tim Tebow? They can make you look good, but they also can fucking fuck you over. Like, niggas control, these people control media, my nigga. They can have the world betray you to the world how they want to.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Or you could fuck yourself over before they do.
Yeah,
that, and make it and use it to your best interest.
Yeah, like best. Yeah, like since now you done fucked yourself over.
Nah, I ain't saying like that. I mean,
that's old fuck up.
Yeah,
but
he fucked himself in another way.
But you know what? I just heard some shit. Like, trolling is part of them, like part of their contract. Like, so you heard? Like, I didn't even know that. Was you be thinking niggas be trolling because they bought? That shit's like part of their deal, my nigga. You have to troll, son.
It's part of promoting.
Yeah. I didn't, like, it's something new to me. So, was 6ix9ine actually, like, really trolling for real, for real?
Yeah, he was trolling.
I mean, like, because he wanted to, or?
But you know what I think would be the biggest troll? This whole situation that they're going through.
Oh, shit.
That is it.
Man, nigga, that shit shocked.
Number one motherfucking troll in the world, if it is.
Yo, goddamn.
If it is.
Yo, imagine?
Imagine.
Nah,
but if they pull this off and it is, oh my gosh, I swear to God.
Them niggas.
They're set for life. All of them.
Yo, I never thought of that one.
Yeah, they did something like 6ix9ine.
Because you don't hear about really, what's the nigga name, man? The manager. Shotty, like.
Yeah, he's locked now.
Yeah, we know he's locked, but like, there's no papers with him. None with Mel Matrix. Nobody. It's just like all focused on 6ix9ine. Imagine this shit is a big troll, my nigga.
Imagine.
Oh.
Imagine if it is, because they give each one of them their own situation that they're looking like gangsters, like they want to look like. 6ix9ine gets to play the person that he really is. I'm not really a gangster. Mm-hmm. It was all me just working based on a contract. Mm-hmm. Now I have a lane.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because he has a lane being a regular person now.
Yeah,
that's right. Known for going through all that shit. And imagine somebody like him coming out. Listen, there's a bunch of rats in the world. There's a lot of niggas out here that are snitches.
Yeah.
So they're still gonna take a liking to his music.
Nah.
They have a whole community.
Yeah, they do. But can you name me one rat that's making music, that's known rat that's making music to this day? Like it don't happen.
You see, I don't know anything technically.
Like,
I just know what people say and what the words are.
Yeah, but see, we got paperwork. There's paperwork on 6ix9ine right now. So he's like the known, he's the known rat. And I don't know what known rat, what paperwork with him that's still hitting stages with, like, you're not sharing the stage with me, though. Jay's not co-signing you. You're not rocking none of his venues. You're not rocking no 50 venue. You're not rocking no Rick Ross venue. Like, you certain venues you're not rocking, even though it's gangsters everywhere. It's gangsters in London, nigga. So I don't know. You know,
Troy Ave situation now, right?
Yeah, but
Troy Ave and his situation are different, but it's similar in one way. Supposedly snitching, right?
Yeah.
Snitching.
But I ain't seen the paperwork though on Troy Ave yet.
But he went on the stand. It was all on the news.
All right.
It was in the open that he even put it out himself saying that he said what he said.
Yo, I'm glad we're having this conversation. A couple weeks ago, I wanted to talk about this. It's some grimy niggas in the world, and it's some niggas who can't handle pressure. Like, it's some real grimy ass niggas out here,
right?
And it's some niggas out here that's stone cold killers, my nigga, right?
It is.
But Toe, Do you think they told because they are snitches or because it's some grimy ass niggas though? Like, I don't give a fuck about this nigga life. Cause you know, like, I was thinking about it. Like, it's no nigga like who put in work, my nigga, and nobody even touched these niggas, and they done ratted on niggas. But I was sitting back and thinking, like, is this nigga really a rat or he just a grimy ass nigga? And he don't give a fuck who he put, like. You know what I'm saying? Like a sleazeball.
Oh, okay. I get you now.
Like yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, these niggas, he was scared and couldn't do the time.
Or just a greaseball.
Just
like
a greaseball ass nigga anyway. Like, the fuck
like
this
nigga? Huh? Nino Brown, or like Alpo.
Exactly.
When Alpo was like, listen, I ain't doing nobody from my hood, but. Them niggas from over there? Like, I don't fuck with them niggas, though.
Alpo, Alpo, nobody still touched this nigga. And he's doing what he do.
Birth perfect. Fucking example.
Like nothing. Like, you know what I'm saying? Because he let shit go. Now, is he a rat or he just a grimy ass nigga who don't give a fuck about another nigga life? Like, man, fuck that nigga. I'm throwing the nigga under the bus.
Right.
Or he's just a snitch. Like,
who knows?
Like, I'm trying to figure out, like, who, like, because I think it's like that. I don't think nigga, like, Sammy the Bull, killer. But he's a rat. Sammy the Bull's a rat. Like, I think because they use that got it. Cause with the Gotti tapes, you let that tape change who you are. Cause you heard like that shit. A tape ain't gonna change how I feel. Like if I'm gonna tell on you or not. Like I don't give a fuck what I heard on that tape. We ready here. We done. Right. Like what? Nigga, you still. I don't understand these niggas, man. God bless these niggas, man. That's why I'm glad I'm trying to. You acting now. You trying to rap? Cause like I said, man, this shit ain't about shit.
Nah,
out here,
man.
And I hope you tell the other little homies like yo something like. It's over,
everybody
man.
Wanna be gangster, my dude.
Yeah, tell like you could talk to 20 young niggas and probably one or two, but fuck it. Whatever. Like whatever come, man. Like
my tape that's dropping March 28th, Loco Living.
Yeah.
I'm talking about shit like that too. You know what I'm saying? Like I'm talking about how I came up with the gang shit, how I came up from that, and then on another project I got Loco Living 2. It's talking about me trying to grow from it. You know what I'm saying? And then it's a lot of dudes that's trying to be that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Which kind of bugs me because the shit I done been through and experienced in life, I'm like, damn, like I wish certain things I haven't experienced. You know what I'm saying? I wish I had the happy lane like certain dudes and didn't have to go through certain things. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Or have to do certain things. You know what I'm saying? So I laugh at niggas. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. I just don't understand.
Right. They ain't gangbanging right.
They're not gangbanging right. And they're like, not.
Yo, when I growing up, my nigga, growing up, like. You was my gang. I ain't give a fuck if I don't know you from a hole in the wall, my nigga. If you ride when I'm riding, you crip, I'm crip. We gonna ride out together, nigga. That's it. Like I don't care if I don't know you, my nigga. Like if I'm in your presence, I got your back, my nigga.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Now, nigga, I don't fuck with that nigga. I don't know that nigga.
Right.
And ride with the other nigga. Ride with the enemies. How the blood popped out of Latin King or beating up one, beating up crip? Like what? Well, hold on. What the fuck is going on? Or the crip in the blood beating up a body? I like what the fuck, nigga? Whoa.
Time changed.
Yeah.
Time changed. Bloods and Crips chilling with each other.
Yeah, but once we're in the system, now you don't fuck with Crips. You never seen a Crip in your life. These homie niggas be bugging. Like, I'm having, matter of fact, my next show gonna be on some homie shit, like, talking about the homies, like, that ass. Like, I fuck with a couple of homies. I fuck with homies, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They're some good, like, some of them are some good people, but I don't understand their mindset, my nigga. And like, remember what I was talking about last time, too? Like, they so grimy, man. They got grimy, son. Like, 6ix9ine situation, just the bag. That fucked the whole bag up, my nigga.
It did.
The Chris one never did that. Nigga, hell no. See, this house now, his homies invested in him. And they still down. He could have signed an MMG, but what he said? He said, nah, my homies from my hood put the money up for me at the beginning. You know what I'm saying? Like, so I'm riding with them. Like, and look now. Look at now. The blood nigga would have been left. and let it be funny, man. Like, if you all gonna join the gang, man, just know what y'all joining, man. Like, for real, son. Like, I don't, like, if you work, you can be a gang member. I don't mind you, nigga. Be a Crip lawyer, please. Be a Crip doctor. Like, I'm preaching some positive shit to people though. I don't, like,
word.
Like my nigga go to school. Word. Like damn son, I got a fucked up record, so I'm certain shit I can't get. But homie, go to school, get that business license on, so you can like so we can go through you. Or be a lawyer.
Be a lawyer. So you can represent somebody us. In a situation, you can represent us.
Like,
exactly.
Man, I don't mind to have a bunch of whole corporate thugs. Like it's Jeezy, like corporate thugs, just chilling. Like if you If you a big homie or you got some type of status in your shit, man, fuck, tell him to go shoot that nigga. Tell that nigga go to the library. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
So tell a nigga, yo, hold this camera, my nigga. Like, you gonna learn to shoot videos, my nigga.
Fact. Yo, we gonna break or something soon?
Yeah, we can take a break. We're gonna play
one of the songs featuring Way Die and A Billion from the 9.
Oh, I heard A Billion.
You don't put a penny for the set, for the set. You don't really bang to the left, to the left. Lame nigga claim he a threat. Till that pussy come outside, he a no-show. You don't really know about the locos. Hit that pussy real close with the fofo. You don't put a penny for the set. You don't really bang to the left.
Fabulous, call me Loso. Marcy P's was my dojo. Loco burning in a low-low. Saka Fest, Sati Coco. Dressing polo, ducking from the popo. Smoking perp, she rubbing on her toto. Your big homie, really not the left. I come outside beating on my chest. You claim that you crip, but I left different. You left the hood a snitch and I left different. I could say I did it for the set, but that be a lie, boy, I did it for the rep. I did it for the fame, I did it for the check. I did it for the ice, put the rubies on her neck. Yeah, I made a movie with a neck. Wait, I shootin' with a tech, yeah.
You don't put a penny for the set, for the set. You don't really bang to the left, to the left. Lame nigga claim he a threat. Till that pussy come outside, he a no-show. You don't really know about the locos. Hit that pussy real close with the fofo. You don't put a penny for the set. You don't really bang to the left.
We ain't in the same book, in the same book. So fuck being on the same page. Fuck fucking with the same bag. I hate to repeat the same things. Gang hit, I gotta hit first. My sneakers speak louder than words. When I'm dead, you be left with your mouth wide. When you lock, you be dead to the outside. Fly, crippin', faucet drippin', loco living. You know where I been at, I'm on some other shit. At 25 I had the rain sport. The front of the Rover looked like the rain snort. All white, stripes on me off white, she snort white. Baby, I was beating it all night. Aye, yeah, we both left the hood, but I left different. Yeah, we both loco, but I left different.
You don't put a penny for the set, for the set. You don't really bang to the left, to the left. Lame nigga claim he a threat. Till that pussy come outside, he a no-show. You don't really know about the locos. Hit that pussy real close with the fofo. You don't put a penny for the set. You don't really bang to the left.
Put your black flags hanging out the left, out the left. Me and my niggas trying to step, trying to step. Certified nigga, you a check. Though you set a blue nigga if you rep. Have respect for all my homies, we up next. Don't have me bust out all your homies with your tech. Walk out with all this money on me, watch me flex, flex. Yo, main bitch fuck your homie, now you flex. Woo, yeah, now you know, now you know. Now they drinking 20 of the dope, of the dope. Bitch, I had to get it, I was broke, I was broke. Put the top down, running with my lows, my low. Sipping all the Hennessy.
You don't put a penny for the set, for the set. You don't really bang to the left, to the left. Lame nigga claim he a threat. Till that pussy come outside, he a no-show. You don't really know about the locos. Hit that pussy real close with the fofo. You don't put a penny for the set. You don't really bang to the left, Jack.
Ain't nobody chiller. I'm still a close killer.
Push. Flatbush push. Just know I'm riding if it ever is a problem. When I'm riding, got that 40 up beside him. Loaded up, getting ready for the show. We all riding, who gon' be the next to go? Just know I'm riding if it ever is a problem. And when I'm riding, got that 40 up beside him. Loaded up, getting ready for the show. We all riding, who gon' be the next to go?
Better forget street life, you ain't loco like me. You ain't gon' never make a dollar off the books like me. Jet cruising through Flatbush in a 6-4. 5 miles per hour like the Flintstones. And you know, okay, okay. My niggas be grinding all day, that's all boys. I hear them screaming loco, that's okay. They know us niggas locos and that's all praise. Loaded up, loaded up, loaded up, loaded up. Check baby girl, now we don't give a fuck. Nigga, that ain't a hood thing, I done took a good thing. We gon' take a good thing, we don't give a fuck. Loco, nick, nick, I will not lose. Like a broke alarm clock, baby, I will not snooze. I play by the block rules, check man, his cousin. You couldn't touch this if you was him, his cousin is me.
I'm riding if it ever is a problem. When I'm riding, got that 40 up beside him. Loaded up, getting ready for the show. We all riding, who gon' be the next to go? Just know I'm riding if it ever is a problem. And when I'm riding, got that 40 up beside him. Loaded up, getting ready for the show. We all riding, who gon' be the next to go?
Yeah. Motherfucking Z. Yeah, Zeke, who else could it be?
Who else?
No leash, I've been a beast, plus I'm down for the feast. Niggas hating, I'm on the ladder while you under my feet.
We
six
up.
Beef like underwear, nigga, everything's brief.
You out of here.
Don't need a molly, boy, he probably gon' keep. Send you back to gym stars, tucked the side of my cheek.
That's
and
true.
I ain't never need a buzz.
Nah.
I already got a plug.
Send
a bail through the mail like I gotta see a judge. Wouldn't budge, do my crime, do my time like a sheep.
Yep.
I ain't lying. Only dime that I'm dropping is a freak.
What?
Street code still intact. Don't affiliate with rats.
Yeah.
Beneficial, that's a fact. Keep my city on my back. Flatbush, gun city, ain't no pity in the trap. Got that new designer zipper in the middle of my act. Pay the odds in my cars, got me sitting where I'm at. Word to God, see my dogs do whatever for the cat.
So I'm riding if it ever is a problem. When I'm riding, got that 40 up beside. Loaded up, getting ready for the show. We all riding, who gon' be the next to go? Just know I'm riding if it ever is a problem. And when I'm riding, got that 40 up beside. Loaded up, getting ready for the show. We all riding, who gon' be the next to go?
All riding, who gon' be next to go? Nigga, it's probably you, my grown niggas, killers. My little niggas got bodies too. They talking about murders and worrying about who body who. Just mind your fucking business, but niggas pull up and body you. That is bitch in here, I'm on her, she on my body too. After I smoke this blunt, she gon' come to show me what Molly's doing. Three some sound fun, so when hitting chicks, then it's probably two. Ain't nothing about me funny, I'm from the hood, baby, Hollywood. I only use that for the weed smoke. You ain't a G, you only banging on the East Coast. You ain't a G, you only banging in your hood, nigga. You ain't a G, you only banging on your block. My niggas TTG, you ain't trained to go, you need to stop. Cause we CP3, we young and ballin', got a shot. In the new bench G, and for the four, we got a drop. Nigga, my crew more deep, we make a call and get the block.
I'm riding if it ever is a problem. When I'm riding, got that 40 up beside. Loaded up, getting ready for the show. We all riding, who gon' be the next to go? Just know I'm riding if it ever is a problem. But when I'm riding, got that 40 up beside. Loaded up, getting ready for the show. We all riding, who gon' be the next to go?
All right, check this out, right? Oh, man. All right. Y'all know him for Money and Violence, but y'all might not know him from that after this. Get it! Yo. I feel like I got an ear for music. Like, I always listen to music. I listen to, like, mad underground shit.
You walk around with
a rap. You know what I'm saying? I walk around my rap. Like, you know what I'm saying? I do free promotion for niggas and shit like that. Like, if you got bars, you got bars. Like, I don't really fuck with the little kiddie rap. Yo, my nigga. Y'all ain't fucking with this nigga. Shit, yo, I'm telling you. Like, dead ass. And it's like, you came at the perfect time, son. Like, you got Nipsey. You got Papa Don. He just got signed to Warner Music Group.
Uh-huh.
Yo. Nah, son. He got some shit! He got some shit for you niggas, man. Yo, I swear to God. I listen to niggas music. I like it. I don't. I'd be like, yo, that's what's up. That's what's up. Nah, son. If you see my face reaction, it'd have been awesome. Like damn. We, he said that? Train to Go. What's the other song? The first song you let me hear?
Which one? You know how it goes?
Left.
Left different. Left different.
Left! Oh, my God. Y'all in trouble, yo. And I'm saying this. Don't let this good music go to waste. And if, like I said, yo, this shit is fire. Yo, I need, yo, send me that. Send me that. I'm bumping. Where my radio at? Hold on. Let me get up real quick. Let me show you. Where my radio at, man? Where the fuck my radio at, man? I'm telling niggas what I do, man. I walk around with my shit, you heard? I need this shit tonight. Man, yo, check this out. Yo. Please send me this music, man. Please.
Definitely.
I never begged a nigga for some music before.
Definitely. Like, you hear that?
And this shit for real, though. My nigga, like.
That's genuine. I fuck with
you. And not because he here either. Because, like I said, you whack, you whack. It is what it is. I fuck with you, but you whack. Like, hey.
Word.
I'm going to say, ain't my type of music, but it's all right. I ain't going to say that. I ain't going to straight play you in your face. But nah, son. This shit fire. And I swear to God, y'all got to support.
Salud.
Don't willing to go to jail for me, shoot for me, and don't buy my shit.
You know what I'm talking about?
You know what I'm saying? If I got 50 niggas with me and I'm selling my shit at $10, what the fuck, nigga? Yeah, help me get up. Help me get up. So all your niggas in Flatbush that be chilling on the block with him, that be in the parties with him, cause he getting paid for a walkthrough, he bring y'all niggas that getting count for bottles and all that, taking pictures, fucking bitches off his name. When he drop his shit, put money in the pot. I don't care if you never play it. Just, support. Because, like I said, he go, a lot of other niggas go. Then, you know what I'm saying? The more doors open for Flatbush, more doors open for black niggas. You know what I'm saying? More, like, you know what I'm saying? Because sometimes niggas don't got talent. But he being around talent, he gonna be like, damn, son, I don't want this nigga to cut me off. I gotta learn how to do something. You might walk in the studio one day, he's trying to make a beat. Like, you know what I'm saying? Because he see you working. He ain't trying to get kicked off the shit, nigga. He trying to stay around. You know what I'm saying? So if he work, he bring some young niggas with y'all. Y'all start working and doors open for everybody else, man, nigga. Don't be like, yeah, but it's my nigga. He nice, but don't buy none of his shit.
Yeah,
like that's corny. Please buy this shit because it's fire. Like it's not corny music either. It's some gangster shit. Now if you like colorful music, then hey, do your thing. But if you into that Styles P, Beanie Siegel. That Nipsey Hussle shit, that, cause like, Nipsey Hussle's last album was crazy. Like, you know what I'm saying? He's speaking that shit, but he also speaking how to, you know what I'm saying? Business, you know what I'm saying? My nigga, man, support your own, man. Support your peoples, man, my nigga. If niggas don't buy no CDs, man, the niggas can't even fuck around with me no more, man. Don't say what up to me. Don't say what up to him. Don't say what up to nobody. Cause y'all niggas some foul ass niggas. Y'all niggas would rather buy a bag of weed than help the motherfucker out. Nah, niggas, it's crazy. Yo, man, that shit. Yo, please send me that shit, man. I'm gonna give you my email, man. Please send
fire.
That. Yo, man. Nah, son, you got one. Yo, you got one. Yo, I can't read, nigga. Now, shout out Whitney's Dessert Shop Treats by Whitney. She got the motherfucking titties. Don't wanna say it on air. She got the cupcakes. You know what I'm saying?
She got the munchies.
She got the munchies. Man, fuck it. She got the edibles, man. But check it out, right? I can't fuck with these shits because one time I went to the hospital or something. Like, I was too high, son. I went through 5 stages in life. I'm like, nah, never again. But if you like these shits, and they look good too.
Yeah.
Matter of fact,
it's good.
His music was so good, I'm taking a piece. And I don't fuck with edibles, my nigga. I don't fuck with edibles, my nigga. And whoever know me, matter of fact, put your
hand. Hold on. Yo, I gotta get there for the
my good. Niggas who know me, right? I know I don't smoke no weed. No, I don't fuck with weed. But I'm so not lying about this nigga music, my nigga. I'ma eat a piece of this edible. Right now, nigga. Dead ass. I might need
help. Why you gonna eat that? Why you gonna eat
that? Because your music is fire, nigga. And I'm not lying. Like, V-Dub, Maniac, whatever you wanna call him. V-Dub, some nigga is Maniac. You know me, you know. You up top with me, you know. I ain't even fuck with the weed. None of that. I don't fuck with weed. I don't fuck with weed, son. I can't handle
That's what I'm talking about.
I can't handle the high. But check this out, though. And this is a motherfucking edible, nigga. This is a body high, too. So I'm going to be fucked up. You're the mother. Now, dead ass, nigga. If I can eat this shit, you can buy the TV. Ooh. This is mad sticky too. Loco.
Yo,
word to my, yo. That's
what I'm saying. Loco living March 28th.
That's been fire. The music fire. I wish I could play. No, play that something in my speakers, man. Yo, hey, can it be my intro music? Y'all need some intro music.
What?
Give me one of them songs, man. like, I don't need no
got
have,
you.
That's it, fire, nigga. Fucking B Dog got the hottest fucking songs out. Y'all ain't here yet, but you're gonna hear on March what?
28th.
March 28th, you're gonna hear that shit. Look, I'm still eating this shit too. Cause no, I ain't lying, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Word to mother.
The support damn, is real. Son. March 28th, Loco Living. You're
no
ready.
Lie, son. No lie. Like I said, I ain't the best video man. I ain't the best. But check it out. You fuck with me? I got you, dog. I got you.
Y'all heard that?
I'm going right to Flatbush, right by the corner, wherever. Shooting blogs, all that. Because we're going to promote this music right here. Because, you know, some niggas make good music, but let it go to waste. They don't do nothing with it. Dude, how the fuck you ain't got no blogs about your album coming out? I ain't got no shit on. Why your Instagram looking like that?
I'm gonna spice
your Instagram up. I got you. I'm gonna support the real, my
Loco.
Nigga. You know what I'm saying? And it's coming from a nigga. About. I just met him today.
That's real.
But through his music, I feel like I know the brother. Because I'm going through the same shit he be going through. So check it out, right? At the end of the day, I'm rocking with the motherfucking UCE, nigga. That's it, nigga. And I wish I had a bigger. If I was like a. My nigga. Yeah. I ain't had no good shit like in a minute, though. Like, you know, I ain't had no good shit in a minute, son. Like, I'm still playing shit from 2000, like, you know? And I'm still, I'm playing my man Hood shit, my son Raspberry Assassin, FLG. I'm playing his shit, my son Spaz shit, Free Spaz and them, Free the Gunners. I'm still playing they shit, because there's no more street shit for me. Like, what the fuck? AR app, he's gone. I need some new shit in my life, my nigga. And I got some today. I'm about to bump this shit for like a whole week or two, nigga, like this. And nigga, there's a problem. Yo, you heard? Shout out to everybody that was on that CD too, man. Who got who rapping? What's their names who's rapping?
Shout out to my dude, Him Legendary, Zeke Way, Young Mizzo.
Zeke Way?
Yeah.
That's my nigga Zeke.
Yeah, Zeke though.
Zeke
Way.
Yeah, big dark skin. Yeah, man. Yeah. I know Zeke from East New York, man.
Yeah.
I met Zeke on Palm with you, Blake and Shutter, man. He got the after hours and shit, Breakfast Club.
Yeah.
Yeah, come on, man.
Yeah.
I know Zeke. I saw Zeke, yeah, right? Boom, well, I was talking about this is your booking, right? So, boom. Zeke was sitting down, right? He was sleeping. That was, he had the whole blue khaki suit on. You know what I'm saying? I know he blood now, but he had the blue shit on. He knocked out, sleeping. Some nigga came. You know, one of them light skinned niggas with braids. You know, a little tough nigga. He probably been in DFY, all type of shit. And he was like, yo, your pop, you're my man. You gotta move, my nigga. Nigga, Zeke was asleep.
Zeke
was asleep. He was like, sleep. He was covered in the bitch because he was a big dude. He's a big motherfucker. And Duke came in and said, you gotta move, my nigga, tapping his leg. Nigga, Zeke got up, choked the shit out this nigga, right? Yo, Zeke's like, everybody come get this little nigga. If I kill this little nigga. Yo, choking the nigga to death, man, nigga. Like, with his chucks on, he had the Converse on and all that. Nigga, you see. Word, y'all just wait, man. Shout out to the Breakfast Club, too. I've been there a couple times.
What?
Yeah, man.
Shout out to Zeke.
He fucking with my man Smoke Bronson.
Okay.
My son, you know, Bronson. He be rapping this shit.
Yeah.
That's how I met Zeke. Word, shout out to Zeke. He got the motherfucking Breakfast Club after hours.
Yeah.
No violence in that shit either, man.
Nah,
it's
one of the
after hours you go to, like, you know, every after hour would be fights and shit. Like, his after hours don't be no fights or nothing, my nigga. Like, cause nobody is, everybody know each other. Like, ain't no new people coming in. It's the people, you see there last week, you gonna see next week. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got the same security, ain't switching it up. You got what I'm saying? So, and it's good. And the look is good, you know what I'm saying? The girls is good. The music is good. Shout out to Zeke, wait, man.
All right, shout out to Zeke.
Yeah, what's up? Hell yeah, nigga, we're going to open up with the music too now, nigga. So we ain't even talk about nothing but the music now. You know what I'm saying? Heavy, this shit is heavy music, man. Yeah, now I'm rocking out with the Manny Experience. We got my nigga BR in the motherfucking building. You know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, he sit right there next Money and Violence soundtrack. Why go to anybody else? Reef, you got your man right here to write it for you. It's a problem. You know what I'm saying? To the left, whatever. And I'm trying to shoot that video too. Fuck that. If you don't like it, you can trash it. But you know what I'm saying? Give me a chance. You know what I'm saying? You're not rocking out with the Manny Experience. I got a motherfucker Ojito. See, I'm starting to sweat. See, I already know I'm rocking now. The fucking shit starting to hit me. I'm sweating and shit like that. Might end up a war hole tonight, but you know what? It's worth it. Good music. Sign us out, man. Yo, let them know where we can find you at.
Y'all can find me on all social media platforms. It doesn't matter where. IG, Instagram, motherfucking IG, Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn.com, SoundCloud. It don't matter where. At BRMALIE. Once again, at BRMALIE.
Shout out to S Street Media. Shout out to me, myself, and I. Shout out to the Maniac Experience. Shout out to motherfucking, follow me on Instagram. Big_Maniac_MMG. Shout out the other one, Maniac_Experience. If you want your Instagram spiced up, you see what I'm saying? Shit looking all Androidish. Holla at your boy, man. You know what I'm saying? Got the camera, got the XR, man. I'm right. Holla at me, man. And make sure you cop that. What's the name of the state?
Loco Living.
Loco Living! Because I'm Loco Living too. I'm about to fucking crying when I go home. Loco Living. I'm about to be Loco Living. I'm about to sign out. Yo, play that music, man. Play that music.
IJ.
Yo!
Hey,
yo,
Lizzo got that shit, boy.
You don't put a pay for the set, for the set. You don't really bet to the left, lame nigga claim he a threat. Till that pussy come outside, he a no-show. You don't really know about the locos. Hit that pussy real close with the fofo. You don't put a pay for the set. You don't really bang to the left, Jack.
Fabulous, call me Loso. Marcy P's was my dojo. Loco burning in a Lolo. Saka Fest, Sati Coco. Trusted Polo, ducking from the popo. Smoking perp, she rubbing on her toto. Your big homie, really not the left. I come outside beating on my chest. You claim that you crip, but I left different. You left the hood a snitch and I left different. I could say I did it for the set, but that be a lie, boy, I did it for the rep. I did it for the fame, I did it for the check. I did it for the ice, put the rubies on her neck. Yeah, I made a movie with her neck. Wait, I shooting with a tech, yeah.
You don't put a pay for the set, for the set. You don't really bang to the left Lame nigga claim he a threat. Till that pussy come outside, he a no-show. You don't really know about the locos. Hit that pussy real close with the fofo. You don't put in pain for the set. You don't really bang to the left.
We ain't in the same book, in the same book. So fuck being on the same page. Fuck fucking with the same bag. I hate to repeat the same things. Gang hit, I gotta hit first. My sneakers speak louder than words. When I'm dead, you be left with your mouth wide. When you locked, you be dead to the outside. Fly, crippin', false and drippin', loco living. You know where I been it, I'm on some other shit. At 25 I had the rain sport. The front of the Rover looked like the rain snort. All white, stripes on me off white. She snort white, baby I was beating it all night. Aye, yeah we both left the hood but I left different. Yeah we both loco but I left different.
You don't put in pain for the set, for the set. You don't really bang to the left Lame nigga claim he a threat. Till that pussy come outside, he a no-show. You don't really know about the locos. Hit that pussy real close with the fofo. You don't put in pain for the set. You don't really bang to the left, Jack.
Put your black flags hanging out the left, out the left. Me and my niggas trying to step, trying to step. Certified nigga, you a check. Thought you said a blue nigga if you rep. Have respect for all my homies, we up next. Don't have me bust out all your homies with your tech. Walk out with all this money on me, watch me flex, flex. Yo, main bitch, fuck your homie, now you flex. Now you know, now you know. Now that you get 20 on the dope, on the dope. Bitch, I had to get it, I was broke, I was broke. Put the top down, running with my lows, with my lows. Sipping all the Hennessy, looking for my enemies. Nigga, you don't wanna see. Ain't nobody real love.
You don't put in pain for the set, for the set. You don't really bang to the left Lame nigga claim he a threat. Till that pussy come outside, he a no-show. You don't really know about the locos. Hit that pussy real close with the fofo. You don't put in pain for the set.
already bang to the left, Jack. You know,
ain't nobody chiller. I'm still a cool killer.
Amazing P.
Love. I roll Kush, cruising Flatbush. Riding through with that tank top. That West vibe on that East side. Let me show you how a Jeep ride. That loud pack of that good good. I ride slow so I look good. That West vibe on that East side. Let me show you how a Jeep ride.
You know what a loco on. Yeah. What a weed at? Cause a loco stash is loud. Loud.
Logo, I'm everywhere, they ain't never there. I'm riding dolo like them logos on them polo bears. Logo, I've been back since day one. I've been back, nigga, since day one. Logo, too many niggas is playing. That's why half of these niggas won't get out. It ain't beef if it ain't A1. All my locos A1 since day one. I roll Kush, cruising Flatbush. Riding through with that tank top. That West vibe on that East side. Let me show you how a Jeep ride. That loud pack of that good good. I ride slow so I look good. That West vibe on that East side. Let me show you how a Jeep ride.
Got the bag in my G-Stars. When I bought we all left here my people. Free my homie behind the G-Wall. Went to the board, they gave him three more. Straight to it, no detour. In your spot like a PR, observe. Guess you ain't here, be y'all good hearted, but don't make me get my hood started. All my niggas gonna ride, ain't gotta push started. If I ain't in it, then I'm airing the throne. After I finish, I'm coming for the air of the throne. Put one in the air and I'm gone.
I roll Kush, cruising Flatbush. Riding through with that tank top. That West vibe on that East side. Let me show you how a Jeep ride. That loud pack of that good good. I ride slow so I look good. That West vibe on that East side. Let me show you how a Jeep ride.
Call me young Liddy cause my flow is lit. And my new joint shitting on my old bitch. Trapping on the old strip. We had old zips, gave the fiends crack, even had no sniff. I'm a photographer, don't make me take a close flick. Toe fist, youngin' working on his anaerobics. Sorry, baby, I'ma kill it, then I gotta go. On the block, I got a chop and I'm riding low.
I roll Kush, cruising Flatbush. Riding through with that tank top. That West vibe on that East side. Let me show you how a Jeep ride. That loud pack of that good good. I ride slow so I look good. That West vibe on that East side. Let me show you how a Jeep ride.